It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day for a beauty word, a beautiful day for a beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? Always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you. So let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Won't you please? Won't you please be my neighbor? Hi there, neighbors. I'm glad I switched my shoes there. I hope you guys are having a great morning so far. I'm so glad you're here with me today. I thought today I'd read you a book that I've been reading lately. And as with most books, I like to read them with someone else. I hope you do too. So I'm gonna get a special guest for us today as we read this book. How's it going? Would you like to come read a book? Come. This is baby Penelope. Say hi. She's a little shy sometimes. Ah. Oh, there it is. This book is titled The Biggest Story ABC. It's by Kevin DeYoung. All the letters right there. That's a Z. A. In the beginning, God created Adam and Eve. B. Everything was beautiful in God's good world. C. Then Adam and Eve sinned and put everything under a curse. D. But God promised to send a deliverer to his people. That's all right. She might come back later. E. One time God raised up Moses to save his people from Egypt. F. God sent flies. G. He sent gnats. H. He sent hail so that Pharaoh would let the Israelites go. I. But after they were free, God's people worshipped idols. J. God gave them judges, but the Israelites didn't listen. K. God gave them kings, but they kept on rebelling. L. God gave them the law, but they disobeyed. M. They needed a Messiah to make things right. N. But God's people were naughty almost all the time. O. The other nations overpowered the Israelites and made them captives. P. Even God's prophets were ignored. Q. Until finally, God seemed to be quiet for hundreds of years. R. But God hadn't left. He was just getting things ready. S. For his own son to come and save his people from their sins. T. God sent Jesus Christ to die upon a tree. U. And 3 days later, God raised him up from the dead. V. So we can have victory over sin and the devil. W. Jesus wins. X. He is our example. Y. But more importantly, he is the yes and amen of all of God's promises. And finally, Z. One day we will live forever in Zion, the new world God is preparing for those who love him. And that's the end of our book. I was wondering, out of all these pages, which page was your favorite? You can even rewind the video and pause and take a closer look if you're not sure. I think my favorite would probably have to be S, because it talks about Jesus coming to save us from our sins. It's a great reminder to me. I think it would be to you guys as well. So let me know which of these pages was your favorite and why. And then for next week's episode, I'm going to be answering some questions from you, my neighbors. So please write in, send me a question, and maybe you'll be featured on next week's show. That's all for today. Have a great day, neighbors.